installing Glacier Base dual combo showerhead. Product details. Item number 899825. Package contents include a hose, two-way diverter, mounting bracket, thread tape, washers, main shower head, handheld shower head, instructions. Made in China, distributed by Home Depot, model number 8469100H, UPC 02890584692. The cost is $39.98. Pros and cons. Pros: easy installation that requires few tools and mostly screwed in by hand. Package comes with everything you need to install it. Combo provides both a main shower head and a handheld shower head. Both shower heads have 5 settings: full, pulse, energy, full pulse, and full energy. Shower head bracket is adjustable. 60-inch hose. Replaces any standard shower head. Limited lifetime warranty. Cons: it can be difficult to adjust the position because the handheld makes it side heavy. The instructions may not be accurate. With me, some of the items that were supposed to have washers in them didn't, and others that I was supposed to put washers in already had them. Glacier Bay products never seem good for short people, which is around 5'2" or smaller. Suggested tools: an adjustable wrench, preferably one that has grooves in its mouth for easier gripping. This type may actually be an automotive wrench. A box cutter or any small knife. Extra thread tape or sealant tape. The kit comes with thread tape, but I found it easy to drop and twist around. Helpful hint: if you have a stopper, you may want to plug it into the drain. You will be working with washers, which can bounce out of your hand, and you don't want them going down the drain. Replacing the shower head does not require you to shut off your water. Step 1. Remove the old shower head. This is where the wrench will be useful. Remove any thread tape. It will look like a white band. The box cutter is good for removing the old tape. I found the old tape came off in pieces. It was like removing dental floss. Happily, this is the hardest step. Step 2. Next, apply the thread tape to the threads of the shower arm. The threads are the grooves near the tip. You should apply the tape tightly in a clockwise direction. You should do 2 revolutions around the tip. After you cut it, smooth down the remainder. Thread tape is not sticky. It feels like the material the gloves your dentists wear are made of. However, it will adhere to the fixture and to itself. The diverter mounting bracket. The diverter mounting bracket not only holds the shower heads, but it also is where you switch between the main and handheld shower head. The cover nut is the part that will attach to the shower arm. The main shower head will attach to the threaded arm. The first washer. The diverter should already have a washer inside the cover nut. The washer looks like a black rubber donut with a hole in the center. If the washer is not in there, use one of the washers that came with the kit. It may look like it won't fit, but just poke it down. Make sure it is seated evenly within the diverter bracket. Step 3. A washer should be inside the cover nut before attaching the diverter to the shower arm. The diverter bracket should be installed with the cover nut on the top, the adjustment knob on the left, and the holder for the shower attachment on the right. Hand tighten the cover nut on the diverter bracket counterclockwise until you can no longer turn it. Wrap thread tape around the cover nut and tighten it 1/4 of a turn with a wrench. Remove thread tape from the cover nut. This was just used to prevent scratching of the chrome surface. The second washer and the main shower head. The main shower head is round and doesn't have a handle. It should have a washer inside of it already. However, if it doesn't, use one of the washers that came with the kit. As I've mentioned before, these washers do fit, even though it doesn't seem like they will. Just poke them down with a hard poke until they are evenly seated. Step 4. The washer should be inside the main shower head before attaching it to the diverter. Hand tighten the main shower head to the diverter bracket in a counterclockwise direction. The hose. Put a washer inside one end of the hose. It doesn't matter which end. If there's a washer already in the hose, then omit this step. Step 5. Make sure you have a washer inside the hose. Attach the hose to the threaded arm on the underside of the bracket. You do not have to cover the threads with thread tape. Hand tighten the hose. Step 6. If there isn't a washer already in it, place one at the other end of the hose. Hand tighten the other end of the hose to the bottom of the handheld shower head. Step 7. Place handheld shower head into the holder on the right side of the diverter bracket. Slip the hose into the holder first and then set the shower head into the holder. The holder can twist back and forth. It may take some adjusting as the right side of the bracket tends to tip once the handheld shower head is placed into it. If you cannot maintain its position, reapply thread tape to the nut and tighten another 1/4 turn. Other information. There are little tabs that stick out of the nozzle on each shower head. Twist the nozzle with your hand to go between 5 different water settings. To switch between the main shower head and the handheld, turn the knob at the left of the diverter bracket. In addition to these adjustments, the diverter bracket can rotate, and the main shower head can also be moved slightly up, down, right, and left. Put a tub stopper in the drain. Remember to remove it before turning on the water. Demonstration. I'm afraid that my demonstration video has poor lighting, but I hope you can see enough to see how to go between the two nozzles and to switch between settings on the nozzle. If you install this correctly, water should come out of the nozzle. Water should switch to the other nozzle when you turn the left knob. Water should not be coming out of anywhere else besides the nozzle. If it is, check to see if you forgot to put in a washer. If you have the washer, then try tightening the piece further.